Hello and welcome to FLIR Primed. I'm Grant Coffey. Chemical events can be extremely dangerous, so identifying the specific chemical can be of vital importance. The first P in PRIMED is preparation. What you need to do is prepare your people with basic chemical knowledge, in addition to knowledge about the threat and maybe the surrounding area, so that they can be better prepared for safety information, PPE, choices, and other considerations to make a safer scene response. Now, identifying the chemical itself, the specific chemical, can be a little bit more difficult. If you don't have the chemical name, chemical formula, or information off the safety data sheets, here's a clue. Try to at least identify the chemical family. That's going to be extremely important. I like to do what I call the three C's. It starts with chemical name. Again, I want to be specific. That helps me know about the chemical. Other than that, I try to use the chemical family. Number two is container. What's it in? Is it released from the container? Is it contained? Is it large? Is it leaking? Number three, context. That's real important because what am I missing here? Is this a unknown environment? Is it a known chemical at a known place with known people that are facility reps? That's very important. In other words, what am I missing? There are a couple specific resources that can help you on scene with unknown and known chemical products. Number one is Hazmat IQ. A program like that has very, very comprehensive, very thorough field guides that can guide you down a path or an algorithm to identify what to do with specific chemical families. Another one is EPA's 10-step. We've got a modified version of that that you can download at the end of this episode at flir.com/prime. Let's talk now about some of the pillars of initial response to an unknown or a known chemical scene. Number one, again, dispatch information. What do we know and what are we approaching, what are we getting into? We'll see that in a later episode, how important that is. So let's look at zones. Depending on the state of this chemical, is it a liquid, solid, or is it a gas? The zone can vary from as little as 75 feet, and we want to be conservative, to as much as 250 or 300 feet. Next, we're going to look at, let's say it's a gas. First thing, toxicity before flammability. We've talked about this before. If it's toxic, that's going to be our first concern, but if it's flammable, one of our big tools is going to be that combustible gas meter. That's going to tell us whether it'll burn or not. Very important. Is it organic, in other words? Won't be specific, but we just want to know whether it's going to burn or not. Second, we're going to look at specific gas properties. Is that gas reactive? Is it heavier than air? What's its vapor density? Those kind of things. Next, if it's a liquid, we're going to want to know the same things. Is it going to mix with water? Is it going to be lighter than water? What's its specific gravity? Those are things that we would want to know that are specific characteristics of our chemical. Next, let's look at something that we can use as a tool in the field. This is a colorimetric strip. There are many different types of these, and this will have many tests on it, but one that we can use, and these are part of that cues and clues we talked about in an earlier episode. What are the tools you can use on scene, like the DOT book or this? This will tell you pH. pH is whether it's corrosive or not. Alkaline or acidic, two ends of the scale. It also will tell you whether it's reactive, like an oxidizer, and other things too, like it's whether it's a chemical, a weapon, agent, etc. Finally, there's a couple other tests that we can do that are pretty quick, very conclusive on scene. One is a rad screen. Now, if you suspect radiation, you should put your PRD on, but what I want to keep in mind is that for you to remember, rule it out, then you don't have to worry about it anymore. So monitor for radiation, rule it out. And then finally, a biofield test. Biofield test, if you suspect biological agent in a powder, there are good confirmatory tests that you can have on field. Yep, chemicals can be scary. It's a nasty business. Using the right steps and the right identification tools, you can stay safe on the scene. We've got a great download called 10-step that you can get at flir.com/prime. Thank you for watching.